Hello, my name is Chris with Metroland Direct, and in today's video we're going to go over what you can do with a D100 base where both the blue and green light have turned off, and you can get them to turn back on again.
In front of me, I have a D100 base that you can see the blue and green light are not lit on top. A lot of people seem to think that this is a defective base, but this is actually working as intended. It's downloaded firmware that is not compatible with the base and almost shut itself down, but you can see the link light still running. It's basically just unusable at this point. The first thing you have to do is you have to be on the correct version on your control unit before you can proceed beyond that. So it will not work with anything release 8.1 or older. And if you have release 9.0 or 9.1, you need to upgrade to the newest service pack. Both 9.0.12 and 9.1.12 will work. Once you have upgraded your control unit, in the next step, I will show you how you can get into maintenance mode, download the correct firmware, and get back to a working base. The next step, after upgrading your control unit, which I will not be showing in this video since I've already made an upgrade video, is to get the base into maintenance mode. To get the base into maintenance mode, you have to hold the pin reset button while plugging in the Ethernet cable. Push in the button, slide in the Ethernet cable, and you should see a green blip, and then you should see the blue light should start flashing, indicating it's in maintenance mode. Just like that.
So after you get the base station put into maintenance mode, the next thing you need to do is access the base station and upgrade the firmware. So you're going to put in the IP address of the base station. It'll bring you to the screen, hit login. And if it asks for a username and password, by default it's D100, but mine was already saved so it didn't ask me. Go to configurations, parameters, and you can see D100MM means maintenance mode. Confirm that all your IP address and your gateway configuration and subnet and all that is correct. In my case, it is right. It was right before it messed up. So the next thing, once you confirm that, is you're going to go to update firmware of base station. Check firmware update. It'll say, do you want to do this? Okay. It'll show you what it's going to upgrade to. You say firmware update. Hit okay. And then you should see in your base, the green light will go from solid or turned off. It should start flashing. That indicates that the base is grabbing a file. It'll take a few minutes, and then from there, it should be running the correct firmware. Once your base station returns to a solid blue and solid green light state, last thing you're going to do is just confirm that the firmware is the correct version. So if you go back to configuration parameters, you can now see instead of saying MM, it's D100_1.2.7, which is the right firmware for the version that I'm running on my control unit.
That's it for my video today. If you enjoyed my video, please hit the like button highlighted here. And if you'd like to see future videos as they are added, please hit the subscribe button highlighted here.